Games. We've got a whole volleyball game going on tonight. There's football practices and Cub Scouts. So thank you for coming. I know we've got a lot watching online. Thank you for tuning in. So you know why you're here, right? We're taking up a love offering. I'm just kidding. You don't have to give us money. We are really excited to share some time together with a guy that I've come to know for the last couple of days. My dad's church and his family have known him for a couple of months now, and really what I can tell you the most about Rafael is that he is a Christian who happens to be a baseball player. The more you talk to him, the more you speak with him, it's really, really cool to hear him talk about scripture more than baseball. He knows a lot about the Bible, and so that's been really, really encouraging to me. He's played with the Braves, he's played in Texas, he's played here in Asheville area. He talks a lot about the Charlotte Stadium, how beautiful that is. And so right now he's playing for the Cubs, and I'm sure you guys have all sorts of questions. So I'm going to ask a few questions. We're going to give a few baseballs away. And so without further ado, let's give him a warm welcome, Rafael Ortega. Thanks for doing this. Have a seat. So I'm going to be translating a little bit, but Rafa, how you doing?
Really good. Thank you guys for coming on. I'm glad to be here with you guys. I'm just gonna enjoy this time with you guys. I hope you guys enjoy, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Rafa, for being here. His family, you've got a daughter, Mari Angel, and how old is she?
Yeah, I have a daughter. She's 11 years old.
11 years
old. And I have a 4 years little boy. So they can be here today, but they're around the city right now. Yeah.
Rafa spent the last couple of days traveling with us, so we've taken him. He's had a Lauterburger. You've had stuffed crust Pizza Hut, yeah. And all sorts of things from here in Cherville. They were at South Mountain today. You've been to South Mountain? Yeah? So that's where they were up today. He got in the water, I think, and in pura agua. So, yeah. Rafa, I've got some questions. You ask them as you feel free. But and I'm going to do some translating tonight, but when did you first start playing baseball? When did you start?
All right. I wish I can do it in English, but my English is not that really good, so I do it in
Spanish. That's all right. You're a good baseball player, so.
Yeah. Entonces la pregunta es,
¿cuándo empezaste a jugar el béisbol?
Okay, yo empecé a jugar el béisbol desde que tenía 3 años.
When he was 3 years old, he started playing baseball.
Yo nací en una familia que se crió jugando béisbol.
My whole family played baseball growing up.
Tengo 4 hermanos y una hermana.
I've got 4 brothers and 1 sister.
Todos mis hermanos jugaron béisbol, no jugaron profesional, pero sí tuvieron la oportunidad de jugar el béisbol.
Now, all of my siblings played baseball, but they never got the chance to play pro.
Y yo fui el menor y desde que yo nací, ellos siempre quisieron enseñarme el béisbol a mí.
I'm the youngest, and so from the moment I was born, they wanted to teach me how to play baseball.
Y eso simplemente llegó a mi corazón y desde que tenía 3-4 años que comencé a jugar el béisbol, simplemente amé el deporte.
So ever since I was 3 to 4 years old, just fell in love with baseball.
Y bueno, como todos saben, yo vengo de Venezuela.
So how you probably know, I'm from Venezuela.
Y en Venezuela, nosotros cuando llegamos a los 13-14 años, es que comenzamos a prepararnos para jugar béisbol profesional.
So when you get to be about 13 or 14 in Venezuela, that's when it gets serious if you're going to be a professional. And there's 13 or 14 years old here? Anybody? 13, 14 years old? Davin?
Yeah. Entonces, en ese momento fue que, o sea, yo pude entender que yo tenía, y a través de los scouts, yo pude entender que tenía las habilidades de jugar béisbol profesional.
So about that age is when, you know, I started meeting scouts, and that's when I started to realize I might have an opportunity at playing professional ball.
Y comencé a prepararme y en ese momento fue que yo comencé a prepararme para
so
jugar.
I started, that's when I started to really prepare myself for a life of playing baseball.
Sí. Y bueno, y ahí comenzó, ya cuando cumplí 16 fue que yo hice mi primera firma para el béisbol profesional y fue con los Rockies de Colorado en ese entonces.
So when he was 16, he signed with the Colorado Rockies. He dropped out of school. No terminaste escuela. Y directamente a béisbol, right?
Sí, en nuestros países, Latinoamérica es un poco diferente porque nosotros debemos tomar una decisión si vamos a estudiar o simplemente vamos a jugar béisbol.
Yeah, in Latin America it's a very different world, so there you have to choose whether you're going to go to finish school or do baseball, but it's really not both if you're going to be serious about it. So when he was 16, he signed with the Rockies, and that started his professional career.
Sí, a ese momento ya me dirigía o a la universidad o a jugar béisbol, y pues simplemente lo que me gustaba debido también a la situación de nuestros países que a veces necesitamos el dinero, pues tomamos la decisión de ir a trabajar de inmediato.
And he could choose college, but the problem is when you are from a country like Venezuela, you don't really have a choice because you need the money. And so going pro was really the only option.
Y de verdad que yo les puedo decir que ustedes están en un país bastante bendecido y deberían aprovechar eso.
And I really want you to understand just how blessed you are to live in this country and how much you should appreciate that.
Yeah, y no sé qué más o menos ya ahí cuando entramos al...
Yeah, and so you went to the Rockies, and from there was it Braves?
Yeah, no, I went to the Rockies. I have a little process. Like, oh, now I want to start speaking English.
Yeah.
Sí, en ese momento tuve un proceso, y bueno, pasé por varios equipos, comenzó mi carrera, llegué rápidamente, tuve 5 años para hacer mi debut en Grandes Ligas.
Yeah, so it took about 5 years of hard work for him to make his debut into the major leagues, because it went from the Rockies to the Braves, and so a lot of time transpired. And he used the word process, which is a word that Rafa and his family and I, we've been talking a lot about this weekend, because process is a big part of our life. Dijiste que tu personaje es José favorito. We're talking about who's your favorite Bible character. Think about that. Who, when you think about the Bible, we think about Jesus, maybe you think about Paul. You start thinking about the people in the Bible like Daniel and David. And for Rafa, he was sharing with us that Joseph, because he was a man who went through a tough process. And so we're going to kind of get the chance to talk about that here in a little bit. Rafa, if right now you're playing for the Cubs, you're playing in the outfield. If you could play any position, what would it be?
Pues sí, bueno, ya después de todo ese proceso, sí, llegué a los Cubs. Y de verdad que fue una bendición. Los Cubs me han dado la oportunidad de jugar en el equipo de Grandes Ligas esta temporada. Y bueno, yo creo que una de las posiciones que yo jugaría es el center field. Es la que siempre he jugado desde que comencé mi carrera y no cambiaría esa.
Yeah, he says the Cubs have really given me the opportunity now. He's probably going to sign with them again this year. But center fielder is that position that they've opened up for him, and that's the one that he really enjoys the most. Any center fielders here?
No.
Pitchers, where you at? Catchers? Okay. Infield? And who likes to hit? So if you've been watching highlights with Rafa, and I want to ask him about this. Oh, yeah. See, this is why I love Rafa. Who loves to read your Bible? Raise your hand. Yeah. They're like, oh, yeah, me, Rafa. That's why I love Rafa, because he's a man of great depth in the Bible. You shared the story with me the other night, the Grand Slam story, and you were talking about you're still in the outfield, and you know it's your turn to hit. Está a punto de pegar, le toca el Grand Slam. Cuéntame la historia otra vez.
Sí, sin duda alguna, esta temporada tuve la oportunidad de pasar por grandes momentos en mi equipo.
So this season I had some opportunities to have some great moments with my team.
Y una de esas es la que tú acabas de decir, que cuando pude pegar ese gran slam.
One of those is when I got to hit a Grand Slam.
De verdad que, o sea, yo he pasado por muchas cosas y he luchado por muchas cosas, pero nunca lo había hecho con esta intención que me sucedieron este año.
And I've been through many things, but nothing like what happened this season, this year.
¿Sabe? En los últimos 10 o 11 años de mi carrera,
in the last 10 or 11 years of my career,
traté de hacer muchas cosas, pero por mi propio esfuerzo solamente.
I tried to do things in baseball, but only out of my own strength.
Pero este año, desde que comenzó los entrenamientos en spring training,
but ever since the spring training training moment started,
inclusive desde el año pasado cuando comenzó la pandemia,
in fact, last year when the pandemic was first starting,
mi esposa, mis hijos y yo,
my wife, my kids and I,
comenzamos a estudiar en medio de todo este proceso, comenzamos a hacer estudios bíblicos.
Throughout this whole process, we started doing Bible studies at home.
Porque verdaderamente no nos sentíamos seguros en todo, con todo esto lo que estaba pasando.
Because with everything going on in the world, we weren't really sure what to do.
Y pudimos conocer a profundidad lo que es la palabra, lo que la palabra nos quería transmitir, lo que el Padre nos quería transmitir a nosotros.
And so we were able to understand through Scripture exactly what it is that God wanted us to know.
Porque más que lo que yo, o sea, yo quiero que ellos entiendan que más de lo que yo he logrado como profesional en el béisbol, yo quiero que ellos entiendan que yo he logrado mucho fuera del béisbol y es lo espiritual.
Yeah, I really want you guys to understand that a lot of what I've accomplished in baseball is great, but I've accomplished so much more outside of baseball, and that's the spiritual aspect.
Y en todos estos años que yo he jugado béisbol, realmente yo sentía que había logrado algunas cosas, pero no eran cosas como tan productivas, no eran como tan fructíferas.
And I did feel like I had gained success in baseball, but it felt like it wasn't things that brought fruit out of it.
Pero una vez que yo conocí la palabra de Dios y entendí que si yo ponía mi mirada en lo que eran los mandamientos del Eterno,
but once I placed my eyes on the word of God and I started to understand the law of God and his commandments,
todo lo demás me comenzó a suceder de una manera sorprendente.
Then this surprising thing happened where everything just started kind of falling into place.
Y disculpa que estoy obviando un poco tu pregunta, pero de verdad que, o sea, cuando yo llegué a esta temporada, luego del proceso que pasamos el año pasado, porque el año pasado yo estaba con los Bravos de Atlanta.
So, because last year I was actually still playing with the Braves, and so coming into this season,
pero resulta que el año pasado los Bravos de Atlanta no me llamaron, no me convocaron al juego, no estuve ni en Grandes Ligas ni en Triple A.
What happens when you play for a team, you don't necessarily get to play on the field, and so the Braves weren't really calling him to play at any moment. He was just waiting.
Y, pero yo simplemente no enfoqué ni mi mirada ni mi corazón en eso.
But what I tried to do was just to not to place my eyes or my heart on the circumstances.
Yo simplemente me concentré junto a mi esposa y mis hijos a mejorar mi vida espiritual más que mi vida profesional.
So what I decided was I was just going to focus on my wife, my kids, and I was going to better my relationship with the Lord spiritually instead of so much focusing on baseball.
Y una vez que yo entré a esta temporada, regresando al tema, tenía como, o sea, pude conseguir este contrato y entonces los Cubs me invitan a spin training. Y una vez que yo entro al spin training, vengo con una nueva mentalidad.
So things started to change and the coach invited me to play, spring training, and then all this opportunity kind of came about.
Y yo pude entender que no solamente se trataba de lo que yo podía hacer por mi propia fuerza, sino de lo que Dios quería hacer conmigo, lo que Dios quería hacer a través de mí.
And that's really when I understood that it wasn't about what I could do in my own strength playing baseball, but really about what God wanted to do through me because of the fact that I play baseball.
Porque es increíble cuando nosotros entendemos lo que es buscar el reino de Dios y su justicia y todas las demás cosas vendrán por añadidura.
You know, Scripture reminds us, and it's incredible, that if you search for the kingdom of God, all of these other things will be added unto you.
Y yo sé que quizás esto es un poco aburrido para los chicos jóvenes que están aquí.
And I know that this might seem maybe a little bit boring for some of you younger guys.
Pero déjeme decirle algo, que yo he tenido experiencias este año demasiado increíbles.
But let me tell you something, I've had the most incredible experience this baseball season.
Yo ya tengo 30 años y en los 12 años que tengo de mi carrera, nunca había tenido experiencias como la que tuve este año.
I'm now 30 years old, and in the 12 years that I've been playing baseball, I've never had experiences like the one I've had this baseball season.
Son cosas que me sucedían no porque yo las andaba buscando. Yo simplemente seguía concentrado en lo que pude aprender el año pasado, que era seguir poniendo mi mirada en la palabra del Eterno y estar en paz y en amor con mi familia. Y todas las demás cosas me comenzaban a suceder solas.
Yeah, and it all stemmed from this thing where, starting from last year, I just said, I'm going to focus on the Lord and my family, and then all of a sudden, all these new things started happening in my life.
Porque realmente nosotros debemos entender que hay una bendición si nosotros de verdad decidimos obedecer la palabra del Eterno con amor y con dedicación.
Yeah, because you have to understand that there is a blessing from God that's available to you, but you have to focus, put your heart on the things of the Lord.
Y yo sé que en la cultura de aquí americana ustedes crecen con eso y lo hacen muy bien.
And I know that even in the American culture, that's something that you guys are kind of born with and taught, and you do that well.
Pero en mi país no es de la misma forma.
But in my country, that's not how things work.
Ustedes, nosotros simplemente creemos en nuestras habilidades y en lo que nosotros podemos hacer y no en la manera en que Dios nos puede ayudar.
In my country, the way people see things is that we have to believe in ourselves. We have to get things done in our own way.
Pero yo le puedo decir por experiencia propia en todos estos años que definitivamente lo que he podido lograr no solamente me ha dado resultados positivos en lo profesional, sino que me ha dado paz y tranquilidad dentro de mi corazón.
But I can tell you from a personal experience that that which the Lord has done in my life has really brought peace into my life that I've never had before.
Y eso simplemente viene porque lo que hemos venido hablando, y especialmente en todo este proceso que no solamente paso yo o pasa muchas personas, el proceso que está pasando el mundo entero, es necesario que de verdad nosotros nos detengamos un momento y prestemos atención a lo que el Padre tiene para nosotros.
And that doesn't just affect me, that's something that you need to think about in your life and the process that this whole world goes through, where you need to stop and you need to really consider what the Lord has for your life and how you're going to relate to Him in all that you do.
Y bueno, no sé si me quiere seguir haciendo otra pregunta porque si no...
He says, if you want to ask me a question, because I'll keep preaching. I know you guys have some questions to ask too, and I want to remind you, we've got a bunch of baseballs that we want to give away, so don't forget to text the number that's on Facebook. Parents, you got Facebook, you can help them out there. And follow Rafa on Instagram. He does have an Instagram. He'd love for you to follow him. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can stay in touch with all of the devotional videos that we plug in there. I got a question for you, una pregunta. Hablas de las prácticas. So as a professional athlete, como profesional, ¿cuántas prácticas hay? ¿Son diarias? ¿Qué hora? ¿Hay ejercicios? What's a practice like as a major leaguer?
Sí, bueno, nosotros normalmente desde que ya llegamos a spring training, que es en febrero.
So spring training is in February.
Y ya una vez que nosotros nos incorporamos ahí, comenzamos a practicar todos los días durante 2 meses.
So once you're a professional athlete and you get there, it's every single day for a couple of months.
Y bueno, ya luego que uno se prepare esos 2 meses, simplemente vamos a la temporada que comienza en abril.
So then we will start our season typically in April.
Sí, ya después que nosotros comenzamos la temporada, ya eso es todos los días. Pero.
And then that's every single day. ¿A qué hora tienes que estar en el estadio?
No, nosotros normalmente llegamos al estadio como a la una del mediodía y salimos ya cuando termina el juego a las 11 de la noche.
So if there's a ball game, I was asking some of these questions earlier. There's a ball game, he has to get there at 1. And he gets home maybe about 7 or 8, because Chicago plays earlier in the day rather than 9.
En Chicago se juega más que todo normalmente a la 1 de la tarde. Entonces, nosotros normalmente llegamos a las 9 de la mañana, nos estrechamos, todo esto, y ya después nos preparamos para el juego.
It's about 9 in the morning, they're stretching. The game's starting later after 1. You guys stretch that early before your games? No? Yeah? Stretching 9 and then playing at 1. We were talking about this with your Grand Slam. You have videos, tapes, sliders, fastballs, curveballs, and you study that. So, what's that like? I mean, ¿cómo estudias a un pitcher?
Sí, bueno, nosotros normalmente durante cada juego con los hitting coaches y todo eso, nosotros nos preparamos, nos enseñan los videos, cuál es el repertorio que tienen los pitches, si tiran slides, si tiran curvas, cuál es su mejor picheo.
They're watching tape constantly, having to study the pitcher, know if he has a slider, if he has a curveball.
Y también durante entre inning, cuando nosotros defendemos y venimos a batear, tenemos iPad en el dugout que nos muestra más o menos los últimos juegos de cada pitcher.
And we do have some iPads in the dugout that can actually tell us how that pitcher has done over the last couple of games.
Y así es como nosotros nos preparamos para cada turno. Ese es como nosotros preparamos nuestro plan.
So that's every single game we have to kind of come in with. It's really a game plan. He's not just going out there and horsing around. So you're in the outfield. Estás afuera. It's the bottom of the eighth. And you have to hit against a guy that struck you out last time, right?
Sí, ese, no, este era un pitcher que yo había enfrentado 2 semanas antes.
2 weeks ago he had faced him.
Y él me había sacado de out a mí.
Struck you out.
Pero finalmente me llegó esta nueva oportunidad.
Then I had this, and I love the way you talk. Me encanta la forma en que habla. Speaking Spanish to you guys and English to him. He says, is a new opportunity to face this pitcher. I like that word, opportunity.
Sí, él es el cerrador de los Rockies en ese momento.
He's the Rockies' closer.
Entonces, nosotros en el octavo, en la parte alta del octavo, en la parte baja, nosotros estábamos perdiendo, creo que era 4-2 y empatamos la partida y se puso 4-4.
So we were losing 4-2, bottom of the 8th, and we tied up 4-4.
Sí, y nada, ya yo nos sacaron los tres ajos y me tocaba defender y en el próximo inning yo era el tercer bate del.
So he's standing in the outfield, he knows they tie up the game and he knows he's up to bat third.
Y pues yo simplemente estaba pensando en que iba a tener la oportunidad de batear y
so I just kept thinking I'm going to have a chance to go to bat.
Y simplemente comencé a ponerme bastante nervioso.
So I got really, really nervous.
Yo me imagino que a todos los que están aquí les pasa eso.
I'm guessing everybody here knows what that feels like.
Especialmente los muchachos que juegan béisbol.
Especially the baseball players.
Cuando tienen un momento, un turno importante o saben que llega su momento, se ponen un poco ansiosos y nerviosos.
Yeah, when you know that it's your turn to go up to bat, you get maybe a little nervous.
Pero yo le voy a explicar la forma que yo utilizo para tratar de concentrarme y relajarme.
So, but I want to share with you guys, this is what I do to try and relax myself.
Yo simplemente trato de pedirle siempre al Padre.
I always try to ask the Heavenly Father.
Y pedirle que me ayude y trato de que mantenga mi, o sea, que mantenga mi ansiedad un poco tranquila, o sea, que no quiero pensar en lo que va a suceder, sino simplemente trato de pensar en el plan que tengo.
I want to ask always the Heavenly Father to help me not have that anxiety, but rather to have peace and to be able to think about the plan that I have to execute.
Sí, porque a veces nosotros como jugadores pensamos en lo que queremos hacer. Yo quiero dar un batazo, yo quiero batear un jonrón, yo quiero dar algo importante.
Because sometimes as hitters or batters, we know we want to get a single, we want to get a home run, we want to do something big.
Y me imagino que eso también le pasa a los pitchers.
And probably the pitchers feel in the same way.
Pero simplemente cuando tú tienes un plan, tú tienes algo ya, tu coach te dice, oye, este pitcher tiene este picheo, simplemente nosotros nos concentramos en ese plan.
But when you have a plan and you got your head coach telling you, you know, this pitcher pitches this kinds of pitches.
Yo me imagino que cuando ellos entrenan igual que nosotros.
Probably you guys, when you're training, the same way that we train.
Hablan sobre, mira, deja la mirada en el contacto, no trates de hacer más de la cuenta.
You talk about making sure your eyes are set on where you're going to hit contact.
Y eso era lo que yo estaba tratando de pensar.
So these are the kind of things that are running through my head.
Y pues sacamos los tres outs y nos toca regresar a batear.
So three outs and it's our turn to bat.
Y el primer bateador del turno se envasa por base por bola.
The first guy gets walked on the first.
Y él viene el segundo y ya yo voy caminando al círculo.
And the next guy's up and of course I'm swinging, getting ready.
Y el segundo se poncha con tres picheos.
The second guy gets striked out with three strikes.
Pero ya yo sé que este pitcher la última vez me sacó out con un slider.
But I know that the last time this pitcher got me out, he got me out with a slider.
Pues en este momento mi plan es solamente ir a buscar ese picheo porque yo sé que él me lo va a tirar.
So the only thing I can think to do right now is to look for that slider because that's probably what he's going to try again.
Inclusive cuando él es un pitcher que tira 97 millas y tiene un slider a 87 millas.
He's got a 97 fastball and about an 87, you said? 87 slider. And so this is a tough guy to face.
Posiblemente tú puedes pensar que él te va a tratar de tirar su recta.
You might think he's going to go straight down the middle with it.
Pero la última vez que yo lo enfrenté, pues como vuelvo a decir, me sacó algo con el slider y yo simplemente decía, él me lo va a volver a tirar.
But since he threw that slider the last time, I kept thinking over and over, you know, he's got to be throwing me this slider.
Y pues yo le estoy contando esto y quizás para ustedes no sea tan emocionante, pero cuando tengan la oportunidad de ver el video.
Yeah, maybe this isn't as exciting for you guys, but if you ever go back and watch that video.
Para mí es bastante emocionante.
For me, it's very emotional.
Porque, o sea, estoy pensando en este momento. Estoy un poco nervioso.
At this moment, I'm nervous.
Estoy tratando de controlar mis emociones.
I'm trying to control my emotions.
Pero al mismo tiempo estoy poniendo un pensamiento agresivo en mi mente.
But at the same time, I have to start thinking aggressively in my mind.
Sí, pensando si este pitcher me deja el picheo ahí, yo se la voy a sacar.
And I have to think to myself, if he gives me that slider, I have to hit it out of the park.
Pero que sea mi picheo, no el de él.
But it's got to be my pitch, not his pitch.
Y pues me puse desde que comenzó el turno a buscar ese picheo.
So from the moment I come up to the bat, I'm really just looking for that slider.
Y él me tiró el slider,
so he threw me that slider.
De bola.
And it was a ball.
Y me tiró una recta muy lejos.
And he threw it down the middle and it was too far away.
Y era 97 millas, pero yo la vi a 200.
And that ball, that one that was down the middle, it was only 97 miles an hour, but it felt like it was 200 miles an hour.
Porque cuando nosotros estamos buscando un picheo lento,
because when you're looking for a slower pitch,
los picheos rápidos se ven mucho
más. The fast pitch look even faster.
Y él me entonces me tiró el slider la recta y me tiró el slider y le hice swing con todo.
So he throws me the slider and I swung with everything I had.
Y di un foul hacia la línea de primera.
And it was a foul to the first baseline.
Entonces en ese momento él se da cuenta que yo estoy buscando el picheo.
So now the problem is he knows I'm looking for his slider.
Y me tira una recta alta.
And he throws me a high fast one.
Gracias a Dios que estaba bola porque ni siquiera
Thankfully,
la vi.
Thankfully it was a ball because I didn't even see it come.
Después me tiró otra recta pegada.
Then he threw me another straight one, a little close inside.
Y luego me tiró un picheo en bola.
And then he threw me a ball.
Y el conteo es 3 y 2.
And so now it's a full count 3-2.
Me tiró dos rectas seguidas.
He threw me two straight on fastballs.
Y le dije, yo dije, va a tirar el picheo.
So I thought, he's going to throw me that slider next.
Y cuando yo veo eso, me preparo, agarro mi aire, me pongo agresivo. Solamente quédate tranquilo, mírala y golpéala.
So I thought, here it's going to come, just take a breath. When you see it, crush it.
Y en ese momento, cuando él me tiró el slider,
so when he threw me that slider,
no, ya no lo vi a 87, lo vi como a 50.
I didn't see it as an 87, I saw it more like a 55 mile an hour.
Lo vi demasiado lento.
And it was just, it looked super slow.
Y yo me pongo a pensar, y era como si estaba en cámara lenta.
So when I think back on it, it kind of felt like it was all in slow motion.
Yo sentí que yo decía, ahí está, golpéala.
I could literally think to myself, there it is, crush it.
Y la golpeé.
And I crushed it.
Sí, y ese fue uno de los momentos más emocionantes que he tenido en mi vida.
And that's one of the highest moments that I've been able to have in my life.
Y tuve muchos momentos emocionantes. Hubo un juego.
I've had a lot of big moments. There was a game.
Quizás ustedes no me lo van a creer.
And maybe you guys aren't going to believe this.
Pero lo bueno es que ya existen las cámaras y están los videos.
But now there's proof for it because there's video.
Batí tres jonrones en un juego.
And I got to hit three home runs all in one game.
Sí, I know. Yeah. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
I can't believe it. I don't know how I did that. Seriously.
Well, Rafa, let me ask you a few more questions. I want to respect his time, too, so we won't keep you guys long. We won't keep him long. What are two or three things that these guys can do, these gals can do, to become professionals in sports? Dos o tres cosas que puedan hacer.
Yo creo que lo más importante que los niños pueden hacer es la disciplina que tienen, la disciplina que tengan por el sueño que ellos quieren alcanzar.
I think that one of the most important things you can do is just to have a discipline for the dream that you have.
Yo me imagino que los niños que están aquí que juegan béisbol se supone que quieren ser grandes ligas.
I imagine that anyone sitting here who's playing baseball, you want to make it to the major leagues.
Y a veces me imagino que ellos tienen sus jugadores favoritos que ven por la televisión.
And you probably even have your favorite baseball players that you're watching on TV.
Y quizás ellos digan, wow, yo algún día quiero estar ahí.
And maybe you're thinking to yourself, man, I'd love to be there someday.
Y ellos pueden estar ahí algún día.
And you could be there someday.
Pero solamente tienes que trabajar en eso, confiar. Primeramente tienes que poner a Dios primero.
You have to work at it. You have to trust. And really, first most, you have to put the Lord first.
Y tienes que entender que no va a ser con tu propia fuerza.
And you have to ultimately understand that becoming a professional, it's not in your own strength.
Nosotros a veces, o sea, las habilidades, todos ellos que están aquí que juegan béisbol,
all of you that are here who play baseball,
tienen habilidades.
You have abilities.
Pero para tú mejorar las habilidades, se supone que tienes que trabajar.
But in order for you to make those abilities better, you're supposed to work.
Pero siempre es importante poner todo primero en manos de Dios.
But before you even do that, you have to put all of those abilities in the hand of the Lord.
Lo digo por mi propia experiencia porque es lo que me ha funcionado.
I just say that from my experience because that's what's worked for me.
Y van a haber procesos de diferentes tipos para cada una de las personas y no ya pueden ser para beisbolista, puede ser para lo que sea.
And the Lord's going to have a different process for each of you whether it's baseball or a different sport.
Pero yo creo que lo más importante es nunca dejar de alcanzar lo que quieres lograr.
But I think one of the things that you really need to apply to your life is to never quit on the thing that you want to reach in life.
Especialmente cuando vengan esos momentos duros porque
especially when the hard times come.
Hablando un poco del béisbol porque el béisbol es no es todo tan fácil, hay mucho, imagínate, un bateador de 10 veces que da 3 hits es un fenómeno.
Yeah, and baseball, he says baseball is not really an easy thing. Here's a guy who's only batted 10 times and he says, you know, 3 home runs.
No,
three hits.
Que batea tres hits, pero las otras siete veces quizás van a ser frustrantes.
But the other seven times you go up there would be frustrating.
Pero sin embargo, si tú bateas tres veces, eres un fenómeno.
But if you've hit three out of the 10 times at bat, you're a phenomenon.
Pero tú tienes que estar listo.
But you have to be ready
mentalmente para esos momentos malos.
Mentally for the other seven times when you're not doing that.
Cuando no lo hagas bien, simplemente continúa, no pierdas la esperanza, no pierdas la fe en Dios y en ti.
When things don't go well, don't quit, don't lose faith in the Lord, and don't lose faith in yourself.
Y yo creo que eso no es solamente para los niños que juegan béisbol, yo creo que eso es para cualquier persona.
And that's not just for the young ones that are playing sports, that's for every single person here.
Yo creo que todas las personas pasamos por distintos procesos, por dificultades increíbles.
I think each human just goes through a process, very incredible things.
A veces cuando nosotros nos caemos que prácticamente nuestras rodillas están en el piso.
And sometimes when we fall and our knees are basically on the floor.
Quizás nuestras rodillas están en el piso, pero nuestra cabeza puede levantarse arriba nuestra mirada.
Maybe we feel like our knees are on the floor, but we can lift up our face and turn to the Lord.
En ese momento es cuando nosotros pedimos ayuda y el Padre nos levanta.
And it's moments like that when we can speak to the Lord and ask him for help and he will lift us up.
Y ahí es donde continuamos.
And that's where we continue.
Sin perder la esperanza.
Without losing hope.
Seguimos confiando en Dios y seguimos confiando en nosotros y cada proceso que vamos pasando lo vamos dejando a un lado y seguimos.
We keep trusting the Lord, we keep trusting the process and everything else, we leave it to the side and we keep going forward.
Con valentía, y eso es como dice Josué 1:9, esfuérzate y sé valiente, no temas ni desmayes porque Yahweh tu Dios estará contigo donde quiera que vayas.
And this is why scripture reminds us in Joshua 1:8-9 that be strong and courageous, right? Trust in the Lord.
Pero,
and I will be with you with
pero debemos ser valientes en guardar en los mandamientos del Padre.
But I think it's really important that you understand we have to be brave in keeping the law of the Lord.
Y eso es lo que nos va a mantener a nosotros fuertes para seguir adelante ante cualquier adversidad.
And by doing that, it's going to keep us strong no matter what adversity we face.
Y también nada, eso yo creo que es lo más importante. Yo creo que me dijiste dos o tres cosas, pero yo dije un testamento.
He said I know you asked for two or three things, but I wanted to give you a couple of thoughts. Rafa, I'll close with this. You are playing for the Cubs right now. You're waiting on your agent to let you know what they say. If you could play for any team, Braves, Astros, which would you play for?
No, yo creo que yo estaría con los Chicago. Ya tuve la oportunidad de jugar con los Bravos en el 2019.
He said I think it would be the Cubs. I played for the Braves in 2019.
Pero creo que la oportunidad que me están dando Chicago.
But the opportunity that Chicago has given me.
Y me encanta Chicago.
Has been great, and I like Chicago a lot.
No sé si alguno de ustedes ha podido estar allá en Chicago.
I don't know if any of you have been up there. Anybody been up there? Chicago?
Y han estado en el Wrigley Field.
Have you been on the field, Wrigley Field? Coach, you have?
Sí. Bueno, me imagino que él debe saber lo increíble, la energía,
lo emocional. He says, you must know the energy. It's incredible.
Sí, bueno, me encanta Chicago, espero poder volver con ellos.
Awesome. And I was thinking about this question too. ¿Tienes un jugador de béisbol favorito?
Sí, bueno.
Favorite baseball player.
Sí, bueno, yo desde que crecí, desde que era muy pequeño, siempre me gustó Bob Abreu, un venezolano, no sé si lo conoces.
There was a Venezuelan fella named Bob Abreu.
Bob Abreu.
And that's the guy that I always liked.
Sí, él jugaba outfield también, jugó mucho tiempo en Grandes Ligas con los Phillies, con los Yankees.
He played with the Phillies and the Yankees as well.
Sí, ese era mi jugador favorito.
En Venezuela, ¿cuántos muchachos llegan a las Grandes Ligas desde Venezuela?
Bueno, nosotros somos creo que el tercer país después de Estados Unidos y Dominicana.
So in the baseball world, there's the United States, there's the Dominican Republic, and then there's Venezuela.
Y bueno, no sé cuántos, de verdad no sé la cantidad de venezolanos que han llegado, pero hay unos cuantos.
He says, but you know, there's quite a few Venezuelans playing in the major leagues today. And Rafa, I want to thank you. I don't want to take up too much of your time. Does anybody have a question? We're going to pick kind of a random question. Anybody? All right, Davin, una pregunta. Dice que está feliz que no escogiste los Astros como tus favoritos. David Bogies?
David Bogies.
Bogies, que se recuerda mucho a la misma.
Oh, sí, sí. Bueno, el gran slam de Bogies fue un gran elán y para dejar en el terreno, ese batazo fue increíble también.
Oh, yeah.
Sí, es un batazo muy emocionante.
I'll have to check that one out. So, I love it. Okay. I love it. Anybody else? Yes, sir.
Ese es el proceso.
Yeah. Yeah, good question. Yeah. ¿Cuándo fue el momento en que tu fe realmente se convirtió en el Señor, como tú dices?
Sí, esa es una tremenda pregunta porque eso es del proceso que venimos hablando.
And he says, that's exactly what I've been referencing tonight, it's that process.
Porque yo he tenido momentos de que he llegado a grandes ligas, pero no he tenido estabilidad.
So I've been in the major leagues, but I haven't had this ability to play within the major leagues.
Y yo entendí desde el año pasado, en todo este proceso de la pandemia, cuando me encerré en mi casa con mi familia.
So when it was really last year when the pandemic hit and I had to be at home with my family.
Que yo comencé a estudiar la Biblia, comencé a entender muchas cosas y puse, o sea, ya no sabes, porque yo a veces me frustraba mucho, pasaba momentos difíciles.
That's when I really started to understand the Bible and I had to open up scripture and I'd get frustrated really.
Pero el año pasado, a pesar de que no me llamaron y era un momento otra vez difícil para mi carrera.
Last year, even though they didn't call me yet, and it was a frustrating moment,
yo tenía paz dentro de mi corazón y me sentía tranquilo junto a mi familia.
I still had peace in my heart even while with my family.
Y entonces yo simplemente traje todo ese conocimiento espiritual hacia este año.
And so then that spiritual wisdom kind of came into this baseball season.
Por eso es que casi todo lo que he hablado es prácticamente espiritual, porque sabes, yo he tenido las habilidades durante toda mi vida, pero nunca las había demostrado como las estoy demostrando ahora.
Yeah, I mean, I've had these abilities all my life, but it's really just been this season where things have really started to change for me as I've turned to the Lord.
Y yo puedo decir que el Padre era un propósito de Dios para mi vida, que entendiera que no era con mi propia fuerza.
And I realize now that it was God's purpose for me to first understand it's not going to be in my own strength, it would be Him through me.
Por eso es que ahora yo no solamente, sabes, yo entreno. Entreno mi físico, pero también entreno lo espiritual.
So now the difference is that I'm training my physical body. He says I do train, but I'm also training my spiritual body.
Y eso es lo más importante, porque cuando tienes tu corazón tranquilo, en paz, confiado en Dios, lo demás comienza a suceder solo.
And that's important because once your heart is at peace, everything else will kind of work on its own.
Y pues sí, realmente fue desde el año pasado que yo...
So yeah, things really, last year, he says last year's when things started to change. And we're excited for the future. I know when you guys watch TV and watch Rafa play from now on, it'll be a little bit different because you've gotten to meet him. And I hope to give as many baseballs away as I possibly can. Since it's not as a big a crowd, I think this kind of gives us a unique opportunity to maybe take a few more pictures than we originally thought. And so what I'm going to do, I know, you know, within COVID restrictions, we want to keep you guys safe and we want to keep him safe. Rafa's heading back to Venezuela, and we would hate for him to not be able to catch that plane because he's been around too many people. You know how things can be crazy. So, Rafa, I'm going to ask you if you would stand on these steps with us. Yeah. And then what we'll do is we'll just take these first couple of rows. We'll go a couple rows at a time. And if anybody wants to take a picture, then we'll do those quickly. If not, we'll pray, and you'll kind of be dismissed. Thank you for coming. Don't forget to text the number on the Facebook page. Follow Rafa on Instagram. That'll just kind of increase your odds at winning one of the many, many baseballs. Amen? So, Rafa, I'd love to pray for you. And if we can all stand, and I'd love for you guys to do this with me. If you could just hold your hand out towards Rafa, and let's just pray together for his life and his ministry on that field. Father, thank you for the opportunity to come before you, to speak of your son Jesus, and to speak of how great you are. Lord, we thank you that you use us here, and that you are using our brother Rafa on the Major League Baseball field. I pray for the people that he influences. I pray for his teammates. I pray for his coaches that they too would come to know this faith, that we cannot do this on our own, that we need your help and your strength and your might. Lord, I pray for each person in this room that you would equip us spiritually to be strong in the midst of adversity, to be strong even when things don't make sense. And just like Rafa said, even when we strike out seven times, Lord, to worship you as much as when we hit it three times. So, Lord, I pray that you would bless Rafa, his wife, his children, his plans as he goes down to Venezuela and comes back. Lord, thank you for allowing him to be a part of our service here tonight. And Lord, I just ask that you keep him from all evil, all harm, and have good blessings for him. We ask this in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen and amen and amen. We've got a few baseballs that we are going to go ahead and give away. Rafa, you want to throw these out?